Loyal, kind, grounded, beautiful, athletic, fun, adventurous, a bit spontaneous. One would think that I'm naming all the characteristics a man slash Jackson is looking for in a woman, but in reality, that's what I found in my bestie, Tara.
Yeah, remembering back upon those days of my life, lying down on beaches under palm trees, rest assured paradise, and living or else I'd rather be tonight. Back there watching sunset setting, take me back to island time. Everything was good, but nothing really mattered but the friends that you love and all the simple things that should.
I've never met a girl with such incredible heart and willingness to share it with everyone. The beauty of my words is that what I'm describing about our friendship and the woman she isn't exclusive to me. Tara makes everyone around her feel this way. It's ingrained in who she is. Everybody thinks they're Tara's best friend.
Back on island time.
I didn't know a single person when I moved to Charlotte, and Tara was the right person to know because she knew everyone.
Around in the sun and the sand, and you know every little thing feels okay.
She's awesome. She is the most amazing person I think I've ever met.
I might just play a little guitar or drive in my car. I just might do, yeah, whatever I please.
I call Tara Baby T, just so everyone knows. It's a really great relationship between my sister and I, and I know that it's only going to get better.
Island beats of the reggae in and out of the beach in the moonlight. We were dancing that away. The ocean's over there, we got sunshine everywhere.
I know we all feel the same way. She's just a smiley, shiny, wonderful light in our life. And then I actually remember when she first met you, Jackson, and it was a conversation I can see actually pretty vividly. We were walking back from Wolfgang Puck's dinner, and you were telling me about this guy, Jackson, that you met, and that there was just something different about him.
I could see those waves waving back at me under auburn skies, golden seas. Warm days and endless warm nights, we'd be chilling island style.
I'd never seen him that way. You can always tell when your child's happy. Belda and I just knew the very first time that there was something special about seeing you two together. Has just been so much fun the last 6 months since y'all been engaged. It's been incredible. Your mother and father have done a great job. Whatever they did to make you beautiful on the inside and the outside is just incredible.
Back on island time. Back on island time.
You've tortured me my whole life, but you're the best big brother anyone could ask for, and I love you both, and I wish you the best.
Jackson, I have enjoyed watching you grow up, except every time I saw you after you were a teenager, you didn't know it, but I always sort of looked at the back of your head. I kind of looked for that little donut to start back there, and it pisses me off every time I see all that hair.
When your legs don't work like they used to before, and I can't sweep you off of your feet, will your mouth still remember the taste of my love? Will your eyes still smile from your cheeks? And darling, I will be loving you till 70.
Tara has this to say about her fair prince. She really wrote a short essay. I'm just going to give you a few excerpts from this time. When I first met Jackson, of course it was the hair that laid me even. He really made me work at it for it first. He kept his cool demeanor, his cool guy confidence at just the right level to keep me constantly intrigued, coming back for more. But he simply could not hide his funny, thoughtful, and loving personality for long. I love that about him.
Just a touch of my hand. Oh, me, I fall in love with you every
God bless you guys. It's good to be here. I know you guys have flown from all over just to be here in the Bahamas today. It's great to join here with family and friends. And Tara, the look on your face as you come down the aisle says it all. Now, we realize you two have been planning this occasion for quite a long time, so congratulations to you. Congratulations to our families. If you will, Jackson, just a quick look around here on the beach today. This is all the people that you and your wife have invited for this very prodigious occasion. Incidentally, this is an expression of a man who just realized he's about to get married.
I'm thinking out loud, baby, we found love right where we are. Let's get it on.
This is a really profound moment for you. It's really a celebration as far as you two are concerned, that in this very moment you believe one thing to be true. And that quite essentially is that you have found the one. This is the one person you want to spend the rest of your lives with. And that's a sentiment we all share with you today by way of our presence here as well.
And the crowds don't remember my name. When my hands don't play the strings the same way. Oh, I know you will still love me the same. Oh, there's nothing wrong with me loving you.
Jackson, I know she's known and loved by many, but you, sir, are the only person she wants to hear it from the most. That's how much your wife looks up to you. And paradoxically, Tara, you become the one person that he believes so much in. You actually allow him to make more mistakes than any other person, because such is the nature and the profundity of your love for one another.
Take me into your loving arms. Kiss me under the light of a thousand stars. Oh, darling, place your head on my beating heart. I'm thinking out loud, baby.
It is now my distinct pleasure by the Commonwealth of the Bahamas, and by the power vested in me, declare you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride. Undue pleasure at this time to announce to you the new, the very much improved Mr. and Mrs. Hughes. Let's have a round of applause for them.
It's been a long time coming since I've seen your face. I've been everywhere and by trying to replace everything that I had till my feet went numb.
First, I'd like to thank both the Mastins and the Hugheses for a wonderful weekend. This is truly amazing, and thank you guys.
That you just can't ring.
For the most part, Jackson was just the biggest pain in the butt for the first half of my life. So he threw me into a wall one time and cracked my head open. And when there was blood everywhere, he said, "There's nothing to worry about. Don't worry about it." Yeah. Something happened after all that he became responsible and nice and caring and all of those other things, probably around when Tara came into the picture. So
sharp gun, heart still beating, but it's not working. It's like 100,000 voices that just can't sing.
Thank you, and I love you and love having you around. And he's not the selfish a-hole that he usually happens to be, so.
Jackson and Tara, I mean, we are so excited to have you in our family, wherever you fit, all the way from damn near son to eighth cousin or whatever the hell you are.
look our future in the eye as I think about why we'll grow old together. I love that we get along. We have such an amazing, simple things that we love. I love the things we have in common, that we always love being together. An amazing shared view of family life, of faith, and the friends that we have chosen as well. I cannot wait to be married to you.